It's been a highly consequential week in the Russia investigation. We're now one guilty plea and two indictments into the probe, and it neither looks like the end or even the beginning of the end. And where things go from here is anybody's guess. What does seem clear tonight is that as the amount of testimony and documentary evidence grows, it'll get harder and harder for anyone involved to tell flat-out falsehoods or claim amnesia when the accumulated evidence might say otherwise, which hasn't stopped President Trump from trying. Here's the president back in February.
Can you say whether you are aware that anyone who advised your campaign had contacts with Russia during the course of the election?
Well, I told you, General Flynn obviously was dealing, so that's one person, but he was dealing as he should have been.
During the election?
No, nobody that I know of.
Well, since then, we've learned that Jeff Sessions had on several occasions, Jared Kushner had in Trump Tower, Paul Manafort had with Jared Kushner at that same Trump Tower meeting, also George Papadopoulos. That's at least of all those we know about so far. He's the member of Papadopoulos is the member of then candidate Trump's foreign policy advisory panel, who pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI, of course. Here he is in March of last year meeting with Mr. Trump. We now know, according to another participant in that meeting, that Papadopoulos pitched the idea of setting up a meeting with candidate Trump and Vladimir Putin. And Mr. Trump, quote, heard him out. Today, though, before leaving on his Asia trip, the president said he didn't remember.
I don't remember much about that meeting. It was a very unimportant meeting, took place a long time. Don't remember much about it.
President's memory fails him there. This is the president who just recently said his memory could never fail him. That's how good it is.
There's no hesitation. One of the great memories of all time.
One of the great memories of all time. As we said, though, it is not just the president's statements that are coming into question. It's those of his attorney general and others.